Welcome back to the OpenVINO channel. We are surrounded by sensors. With OpenVINO, we usually talk about cameras, but there are many others. In this video, I'd like to show you an example on how to quickly build a full pipeline with a digital streamer that analyzes both video and audio inputs. The implementation options are endless. In this example, I thought about a smart city camera that not only can detect an accident, but can also hear it. Hear the crash, hear the crowd, and so on. This is a typical video processing pipeline. You've seen it already. See how we construct and run such pipelines in minutes in one of our previous videos on the DL Streamer. But here, instead of displaying the video with the detected objects, we would like to overlay also the sound we detected. So, as we explained in video 66, just YouTube OpenVINO 66, GST buffer is holding all the data that can be written and read by every pipe stages. We will keep the detected objects over there and add a new object for every sound that was detected. This is the audio pipeline we described in video 77. And here again, we do not want to display the results, but rather to combine the two together. And of course, a major consideration is how to synchronize the event. We need to make sure that the vision and the audio events are synchronized. So we will have the detection results into a temporary file. This is only one example on how to do it. It's pretty simple. And here comes the new part. We will use a custom Python element that will read the objects detected from the GST buffer and the sound events from the temporary file. The script will synchronize the events and overlay the audio event into the GST buffer and eventually display the results. This is how our pipeline really looks like. We have one MP4 file as a source, and after decode, we split the processing into an audio and separate video pipelines, which are combined by the Python script at the end. This is the GST command line. You can run it as is or in a script. Let's see it stage by stage. It's simpler than it looks. First stage is to get the video in. This is a street view video that also have the traffic audio. Audio has to be resampled. Make sure it's in the right format that we can process. And now we perform the inference on the audio. You can see the details in video 77. We're using ACLNet model. You can see the XML and the JSON file for sound classification. And we take the detection results, store it, JSON format, into a temporary file. The Python element will read these detection results from the temp file, will align them to the vision event frames, and display the labels to screen. And here, we're performing the object detection. You can see the IR files of the model and the JSON file. And we're calling the Python script and asking for a specific class, audio event watermark, to be run. And display the results as always. This is how my directory looks like. I have here an input video. This is a city road with lots of traffic, and you can also hear lots of sounds. And I have an objects list to detect, and a list of sounds to classify, car horn, speech, and others. I'll change the confidence level. Under models, I have the models, the crossroad detection model, and the sound classification, ACLNet, the IR files, and JSON files, and the Python script. Let's take a closer look at it. We start with importing the right libraries. Then we define an audio event as holding the event start and end time, the type and confidence of detection. And we read the YAML files into sound list and object list. And we're launching a thread that will constantly read the changes in the temp file buffer. And we load the sound list and the object list. This is what we run in the thread we just launched. We are reading the temp file and loading each line in JSON format into the audio events. And here we process them. Until we're not at the last event, we're loading the event we read into last event. We load the time window and confidence, and now we look at the objects detected. If any of the objects is not in the object list or detected at too low confidence, we do not need it, so we can remove it. We examine the last event. Is a timestamp inside the last event timing window? It should be bigger than the start and smaller than the end. If this happens and the event is one of our types and in high enough confidence level, then add this detection to the list of regions to the GST buffer. We're drawing a 100 by 100 rectangle and display the class, the event type. And this new region, the audio detection, will be displayed like any other physical object that was detected. And that's all, running the demo. You can see the detection of the objects in the street, the cars, and the people, and the sound classification on the left upper corner. A great example how to build multi-sensor workloads using DealStreamer. There are many ways to do it, and you can combine many other sensors, but what I specifically like here is how easy and fast you can actually build such a prototype and make it run. I'm sure you'll find great ways to use it. Subscribe to the channel to get more videos like this one. Thank you.